I have something for you today.
Hallelujah.
Say it.
Yes.
Say it right now. But those that are ready to really walk out of it.
Yes.
Those that are ready for God to come and visit you. And take you away from something that gets you out of it. Holding on to you. You holding on to him. God said, my visitation. Whether it be here, whether it be in your home, whether it be in your car, whether it be in the job, whether it be when you think you're going to go through home, yes. Oh, yes, every time there comes a sound of my voice today, he's going to visit you. He said it's going to be your choice to say, okay, God, I'll obey. It's going to be your choice to say, okay, God, I'll obey. Somebody said it's my choice. Get your Bible, turn to me tomorrow. No, go to Genesis. Thank you. Let's go to Genesis. Father, check. Father, check. Father, check. Father, check. Come on, Bible's on the back table. Let's move, let's move. Bible's on the back table. Everybody in the Bible. Church Bible.
Amen.
With Brenda, church Bible. Amen. I need for you to see so you can say, she said, no, she ain't said nothing. The word says. Jonathan, let me try to get a mic for me. Read for the feet. I'm not holding. The 22nd chapter. I'm sorry. Please. I have to obey. So she's about to get the mic. Amen. Forgive me. Amen. I never did this, but that's where she started. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Forgive me. Get a mic, please. Genesis. The 32nd chapter. Start with 2:1 verse. If you had it, say amen. You don't have to say amen. Thank you. But you don't have to stand for the reading. Genesis. And this is a very familiar passage.
Genesis, the
32nd,
24th verse. If you had it, say amen.
Amen.
You don't have to say amen. Everybody got it.
24. Minister Jacob, I'm sorry, Minister Jacob, while he got that, get Mark the 5th chapter for me. When he's finished, we're going right to Mark. Mark the 5th chapter, and we're going to start with that first verse. Genesis 32:24.
And Jacob was left alone.
He was left where?
Alone.
He was left where?
Alone.
Go ahead.
And there wrestled a man with him until the breaking of the day.
Mm-hmm.
And when he saw, he prevailed not against him. He touched the hollow of his thigh. And the hollow of Jacob's thigh was out of joint. As he wrestled with him.
Read 25 again.
And when he saw that he prevailed not against him, he touched the hollow of his thigh, and the hollow of Jacob's thigh was out of joint.
That visitation. Go to Mark. Minister Ricky, Mark, the 5th chapter.
They came over unto the other side of the sea, into the country of the Gadarenes. And when he was come out of this ship, immediately there met him out of the tomb a man with an unclean spirit.
With the what?
Unclean spirit.
With the what?
Unclean spirit.
What is that saying? With the what?
Unclean spirit.
Go ahead.
Who had his dwelling among the tombs, and no man could find him. No, not with chains, because that he had been often bound with fetters and chains, and the chains had been plucked asunder by him, and the fetters broke it in pieces. Neither could any man hang him. And always, night and day, he was in the mountains and in the tomb, crying and cutting himself with stones.
He was what?
Cutting himself with stones.
He was what? Crying and what?
Crying and cutting himself with stones.
He was what?
Crying and cutting himself with stones.
Go ahead.
But when he saw Jesus afar off,
when he saw who?
Jesus.
When he saw who?
Jesus.
Go ahead.
Afar off, he ran and worshipped him.
He did what?
Ran and worshipped him.
The same man that was sitting doing what to himself? Crying, cutting, and what? He was destroying his own self. Why? Because he had a what? Anybody in there right now, thank you. Hold it, but please hold it. Anybody in there right now, not going to do any harm to themselves.
Amen.
In your right mind.
Amen.
But can I take this from the natural into the spirit?
Amen.
Follow me. In the spirit, we're cutting, we're crying, within ourselves. In the spirit, we're cutting ourselves. We're destroying our own self in the spirit.
Amen.
Why? How? Weeping. Because you can't do an unseen spirit. And every Sunday, we walk through the doors of the sanctuary. Who do you expect to meet here?
Jesus.
Do you expect to meet him here?
Yeah, I was
waiting.
So the brain is supposed to be already.
Amen.
He's supposed to come to the door with us. But that's not the case. We come here, and you see what I said in the spirit, allows us to damage the wounded. We destroy in the spirit. We're just like this man, this unclean spirit. He saw Jesus from afar off. And what did he begin to do? He ran to worship him. In his mental state, in the state that he was in the mental capacity he was in, because anybody was cutting himself, something wrong with him.
Amen.
But even in that state, it seemed like he wanted Jesus. So we use that. I'm going to use that because we use this, but excuse me. I'm doing it. I still want Jesus. I love Jesus. But we're going to see what happens. Now, say you can't come as you want. Come as you want. Bring all your imps, your whatever you're dealing with, bring them on to the house of God. But when you get into it, you understand the presence of God. It should be a change.
Yeah, that's
right.
That's right.
He, I think he had one of the biggest demons. I think later on in the Bible called him legions.
Yes.
So I pray we ain't got legions. I pray we got other demons or things that we wrestle with. So if God can do it for him.
Amen.
Amen. That's right.
We can continue here. Let me show you what happened. Six.
But when he saw Jesus afar off, he ran and worshipped him, and cried with a loud voice, and said, "What have I to do with thee, Jesus, thou Son of the Most High God? I adjure thee by God that thou torment me not."
Okay, so we know we're dealing with something, but we don't want God to whip the hell out of us to do whatever he needs to do to get with us, so we call ourselves bargaining with God. We call ourselves, okay, justifying what we're doing with God. Making a point of trying to tell God, okay, God, I'm doing it because A, B, C, and D. That's what we do. And here he's saying, don't taunt me. Look, he already knows what's coming. He already knows that when Jesus steps on the scene, and Jesus confronts him, that it's going to be a change. He knows what's going to happen when Jesus gets in the presence of God. So already he came with anything. Don't taunt me. Don't take me through that. But God will take us through that. He's in the business of it. He's going to take us just through that. Go ahead to the next one.